Does ESPN think Ohio State's going to have the most dominant season in 2022? Maybe. I know one thing. If you're a Buckeye fan, 2022 is going to be very scary for, you know, anybody who has to come across the Buckeyes. What's up, y'all? DJ the Sports Blurred here. I'm back again. Did y'all miss me? I have a great video for you today, especially if you're an Ohio State Buckeye fan. But first, I wanted to say smash that like button and consider subscribing if you're a fan of college football or if you just like to hear me rant. So I'm going to get into why the Buckeyes, or why ESPN says the Buckeyes might have their most dominant season yet. But first, I wanted to share something that I just found interesting. If you know anything about me, you got to know I'm a fan of the Cincinnati Bengals. I mean, I have been with the team since even before John Kitna was our quarterback. Before we were consistently bad every year. We were one of the worst teams of all time. But, you know, that's all changed with the arrival of Joe Burrow. He's made being a Bengal fan cool again. You know, as we look to the Super Bowl, that's going to be played this weekend, I decided to kind of look around and see which colleges and conferences are going to be the most represented. And I don't think it's any surprise that the SEC leads the pack. They have so much talent down in the South. It is crazy. The Big Ten is second with players in the big game, followed by the Big 12 and then the Pac-12. But also what I wanted to do is look at the schools. I wanted to see, you know, what schools produce the best talent. Might surprise you a little bit too. So ranked number one, tied. There's two teams tied for number one, and they both have five players playing in the big game. It's LSU, no surprise there. And also the Florida Gators. I bet you thought it was gonna be Alabama, didn't you? So LSU has Odell Beckham Jr., Andrew Whitworth, Joe Burrow, Ja'Marr Chase, and Tyler Shevlin. While Florida, they have Van Jefferson, Brandon Powell, Vernon Hargraves. I can't talk today, I just got off work. It's like 10 o'clock at night, and here I am making this video. Vernon Hargraves, Fred Johnson, and Evan McPherson. And just to kind of go over, you know, the rest of the players, or the rest of the teams here. There are four players from Georgia, four players from Clemson, four players from the Oklahoma Sooners. I mean, they have a lot of talent. Say what you want about Lincoln Riley. He was down there recruiting with the best of them. Bob Stoops left him a heck of a program. And, you know, he took it and ran. And he ran to USC with it. So to get back, there's four players from Ohio State, and there's four players from Washington, Alabama, Texas A&M, and Purdue. They all have three players. So the one thing that sticks out to me most about this is that the rich just keep getting richer. I mean, college football is about the power conferences. The smaller conferences just get the crumbs that are left over after the big dogs of college football get done eating, and this just proves it. You know, with the NIL deals that are getting passed around, the gap is only going to continue to widen. You know, and I'm not mad at that, because I think these kids should be able to do what they want in terms of making the best decisions for them and always looking out for their best interests, and not necessarily the best interests of the universities. You know, these big time programs, they'll continue to get the best players because they'll continue to put out the best offers. And, you know, smaller schools can't compete. There's one school maybe that might change that. You know, Deion Sanders and Jackson State, they're doing some really great things down there. You know, Deion Sanders looks to be like an outlier. He's a huge personality, and he's getting a lot of really, really good talent to come to his school because he's able to sell what he's pitching, and they're believing it. So, you know, I'm not sure how much longer he's going to be there, but while he's there, I know they're going to be building. He's making a lot of moves. He's an elite recruiter, and he runs his program very well. So I'm not sure why Florida State still has not hired him, but I digress. So now, speaking of big schools, ESPN just recently released their list of the top 25 teams based on returning production. So what this means is that they took all the players coming back to their programs, and they looked at all the teams, and they graded them based off of how many starters and skill players returning back to their positions. So the vast majority of Ohio State's production on both sides of the ball will be returning in 2022, which is far more than any of the last season's other title contenders. So it makes the Buckeyes one of the most dangerous teams looking ahead to the next season. So the Buckeyes, in my opinion, would have been in the college football playoffs again had it not been a terrible loss to Oregon early in the horseshoe. C.J. Stroud looked like a freshman that game. He was getting blitzed from everywhere. He didn't look like he knew how to read coverages. He was really, really playing bad, terribly. And then also the Buckeyes lost late. I mean, they lost in the season finale to Michigan Wolverines. Michigan had a miracle season. They came out and did a whole bunch of things well. And I mean, kudos to them. But I truly believe had they gotten in the playoffs, they would have been a tough matchup for Bama and Georgia. And to take it a step further, I believe that at the time, Ohio State was playing the best football in the country. If you look back at it, I mean, they were coming off of 9 straight wins, including a 56-7 victory versus Michigan State. Michigan State was ranked number 9 in the country at the time and lost by 49 points. C.J. Stroud was starting to come into his own, and the defense was holding steady. I mean, granted, they weren't playing great, but they were pretty solid mostly. So going into next season, the Buckeyes are going to be reloading. They have the number 3 ranked recruiting class. Ryan Day has completely overhauled the defense. You know, he practically fired every defensive staffer, coach, assistant, whoever, you know, from last year. And so when you pair a defense that could potentially be ranked in the top 10, I mean, they have studs everywhere. Ohio State, if you know one thing about them, they're always going to recruit well. So they have studs everywhere. And when you pair that with an offense that was number 1 last year, and these components of this offense are coming back, that's something special. And so let's get into what this article wrote about Ohio State. So with 76% of its production returning in 2022, 70% is going to be on the offense and 80% on defense. Ohio State ranks number 24 in returning production and is one of just 2 teams to finish in the top 10 last season to return more than 70% of its production, with Michigan State being the other team. You know, Michigan State ranks number 42 with 72% of its production returning. So I know I just spit out a lot of things, but kind of follow me here. In contrast, Alabama ranks just 65 in returning production, with just 65% of its production returning, while defending champion Georgia, the Bulldogs, they rank number 96 with just 59% returning. Michigan ranks number 67. They have 65% of their percentage returning. So just again, really think about what that means. So you have 65% of the offense. That means you have the wide receivers returning, the quarterbacks returning, the running backs returning. On defense, 65% of the defense returning, the production, 65% of people who made tackles, 65% of the guys who had INTs, you know, pass breakups, all that stuff. So on offense, Ohio State returns a Heisman Trophy finalist at quarterback, a running back who had arguably, you know, the best freshman season in school history, and a receiver who already broke multiple single game and single season Ohio State records. You know, on defense, the Buckeyes return even more production than on offense. And, you know, they added one of the better picks in the portal, who was Tanner McAllister. But the key during the offseason will be the changes that Jim Knowles is going to be making by taking over the defense. So the Buckeyes have the pieces to be one of the most talented and most experienced teams in the country, which leads to pure dominance. They just need to put this all together. And as I look around the college landscape, I see a lot of teams reloading and getting better. I mean, Bama was young last year and they ended up in the national championship game. Clemson, in my opinion, they won't have another season like they did last year, and Georgia will be ready to defend its title. But the Buckeyes are the most intriguing team to me. They have all the pieces in place to be a legitimate contender for the crown. They just got to go out there and perform. So Let me know what you think about this video. Let me know what you guys think. Will Ohio State really be that dominant? Am I just reading a little bit too much into an ESPN column? Maybe, maybe not. I just know I like my guys and I'm going to ride with them. Again, man, I appreciate you guys for checking in with me. If you haven't already, please like the video. Please subscribe. Please sign up for all the notifications. Do all that. And until then, I have nothing left to say. I got some. Oh, also, I do want to say this. I got a little bit too ahead of myself. I have some videos coming out again later this week. Got some really good stuff for you guys. I appreciate all the comments that you guys have been leaving for me. Even the ones who have been trolling me. I really appreciate that. I just like talking college football. So I appreciate anybody who's taking the time out of their day to join me and in my videos. Now, until then, I got nothing left to say. You guys take care.